Day three recap. Today was master the finish, right? Shooting, very important to us, something we work on a lot, something we have a lot of experience with. So what we wanted to work on is some skills, right? As we said before, we're a skills organization. That's all we do, different than a team training. We have less players. We just focus on the technique. We don't focus on the tactics so much. We can check in your shoulder, being where, positioning, how to move your body, but we know the teams are really good at that, especially a lot of the ones we work with, like FC United. So we focus more on the individual components, so when you get in the game, then the tactics become much easier, right? You can trap it. You don't have to worry about the trap. So today, we decided, hey, a lot of players, we want to get them some skills. So we started off with a fake shot, fake pass, super important. If you're a center back, it's a fake long pass. If you're an attacker, obviously, it's a fake shot. So when you do this, the key is you got to sell it. We said Hollywood, right? We joked around with them. We said you got to sell it. So you got to put it out, look up, get the ball out in front of you like you're going to shoot it, and then cut it in like this. But the key is I'm using my arms to simulate balance, right? I'm here. My arms are up on the way there to simulate balance. You don't want them to put their arms up at the end just like this and go like this, because that's not going to fake it as much. When you see someone shoot on the way there, they take long steps. They use their arms for balance. First one we said cut across your body, right? And this can be done with both feet. So I'm here. I cut across, it can be done with both feet, right? Or with the left, I push it out here, I cut it like that. See, it's a great skill. And we do with the left, we get back in our strong foot, right? And when you would use this is if you're in a tight space, defender's coming, you're not sure you have the shot off, but you think you might, or you have a bad angle, and then you fake the shot, and you could still, or cross or pass, and you can get yourself a better angle. So two situations, right? And it takes a lot of composure. For me, one of the most underrated skills in general in youth soccer. You see it at the pro level, you'll see it a lot, right? But in youth soccer, hard teach a skill. I think this has to be fantastic to get that composure. So we did that. We did a showcase, had some players that did it really well, cutting right and left. And obviously, they can easily do that for their pro work. Once they can get the ball out, hands up on the way there, turn this foot so the hips are turning, turn my left foot. If you can, turn the right foot a little bit, kind of like we did the first day with the pro work on the cutting, or that first cutting drill, man, master the ball, and then cut it across. Same thing, other side. There was one other we did, which was pushing the ball out and kind of a fake shot in the same direction. So I'm here, I fake it in the same direction, and I push it with me like this. Very important one, I think very, very useful as well. If we can be here, I'll show you again. Now I don't cut it, but the player comes in. I fake it, same thing, I get the ball out of my body like this. I get my arms up, I fake it, and I push it in the same direction. So most of the time, we want the players to go like this, and now we're still on our strong foot, if we're on the right side. Left side, you're still on your left foot, but it's just a different variation of it. And there's other variations as well, but like I said, I think very important, all of these fake shots. We gave them a couple different tools, and that was the start. And pro work, very simple. Just work on the cuts, right? If we want, we can add in a trap as well, right? So I can be here. If I was doing it with my left, I can play it off. I can take it. Sorry. You might want to use two touches here. I take it out. I push it. I fake it. I cut it. And this is actually going to make it more game realistic as well, right? And maybe we can do the same thing with just kind of getting out of our feet, depending where the goal is. Say the goal is maybe a little bit more over there. Well, I push it out, fake it, cut it across, right? So we use the second day's work to kind of add in here. And maybe we're not going to do as much of the stuff we did on master the ball. But like we said, it's the first day, but it's involved here. The cut is involved there, if that makes sense. Now you're just using the arm, so it's building off that. So by working on the fake shot cut, well, you're working on what you did the first day as well. So, of course, can we complicate it? Yes, but is it game realistic? Maybe not, to add in a pullback. If I cut it here and add in a pullback like that real quick, that's not game realistic, right? So maybe we don't do that right now, right? It's not right to layer everything in just to layer it in. So that will be the pro work, doing it standing still, maybe 40, 50 reps, a couple days a week, and then we add in the first touch. Like I said, you're here, take the ball out, fake it, cut it, right? Simple, and it makes it more game realistic. And you can even have a dog, friend, or whatever running in as well. So that was fantastic. Then we tried to apply that. We had a little competition where they're shifting the ball, faking the shot, faking, trying to get their player up in the air, their foot up in the air. We even said you can kick it through their legs. If they stick their foot up, kick it through their legs. We just had a player that did that, a U17 player, in a big game on TV, right? So it's a very useful skill. It's something we teach. After that, shooting technique, right? And shooting technique, we gave them an opportunity to get a lot of reps. We gave them a drill kind of where they can shoot the ball. They wouldn't have to shag the ball, really like it. It's good for these camps where there's not as many balls, because what we try to do is get them a lot of good reps, right? It's not about just reps, but a lot of good reps, not chasing balls, not waiting in line, whatever it is. So the key here, we say, when you're striking ball, always hit a moving ball, and we're not going to shoot it right now so much. I may hit one in here, but the idea is, can we get them to get the ball out of their feet? If it's too close and you take that last step like this, look how far back my leg is, right? We need the leg back really far by taking a long step like that, right? And it's a step. I'm not pulling my leg back. I'm just taking a long step and my leg is already back. And then we drive through it. Don't want them kicking their legs really high, right? Because there's a couple different techniques, right? Curving and stuff where your leg may come higher, but let's work on just driving through it. So we say, hey, keep your body over it, chest down, drive through it, keep your leg low, and you'll see I'm landing on my shooting foot here. So I'm here, the ball's on an angle, diagonal angle here too. Put the ball on a diagonal angle, I turn my foot, land on my shooting foot, right? So we don't want it straight in front of us, 45 degrees for them, diagonal, not straight in front. Sometimes do the kind of the, I don't know what you call that, gator chop, to meet in the middle. That's where we want it. So I'm here, I put the ball out, diagonal angle here. I get my head up, let it get out in front, turn, and then I drive through it. So I turn my foot, my hips will turn with it, right? So I like to go from the base up, right? So I push it out, I'm here, and I kick through it, right? I didn't kick the ball there because I'd rather not destroy the camera, but I'll try to give you maybe one gum in this way. Really close to the goal, but you get the idea. You get to see it a little bit. Come to our trainings. We'll definitely demo it for you. But that's the idea, right? What I see mostly from players is mistakes, not turning their foot, right? Or they're kicking up really high. They're trying to use their hip flexors to kick up. Obviously, at an advanced level, it's hard to get them to push off their foot. They go like this, but we want them to be here. We want them to kick and push off their leg, push off the plant leg, so then they land on the shooting leg, okay? So if I'm here, maybe show you one right in the net here. I push it out here. I push it, and then I land on my shooting foot. And once again, look at the plant foot here. When I push it out, I put it on an angle. I look up, I let it get out, and I push so hard off this leg that I land on my right leg. Very difficult technique. Like I said, common mistakes you'll see is that's one of them. They like to kick up with their leg high. I call it kind of like, you know, this dance or cheerleader kick, whatever you want to call it, where it comes really high. We don't want that. You see when I kick it, everything's pretty low. My whole body goes forward. I land in front of the ball. I think that's really important. So that's what we try to teach them. Obviously, laces. A lot of players will also do this. They'll open up their foot, laces, right? So, pro work, something we want the players to do, as always. Take the ball, push it against the wall, set it up, hit a shot, right? So, if I'm doing this with my right foot, so we take something from day two. Maybe I'm here, I push it out, I get the ball out of my feet, I turn, and then I hit it, right? So now we're adding that first touch, getting out of my body, and shooting. And it can be done the same from the different angle, right? We do the other touch we worked on, where you're not pulling it, opening up, but I'm here, I push it out of my body, and that touch will probably be more realistic for the players, right? Because the pull trap is a little bit harder. If we want to get really fancy, potentially, well, now maybe it's like I play the ball, we add in something from day one here as well. We give one of the quick dribbling moves in here. I'm here, maybe I stop it, I pull, push, and then hit, right? And I got to make sure this is good. Sorry, I'm just kind of going with it. I stop it, I pull, jump back, push, get it out, and shoot. So all things we can do, combining things, it's a little bit more game realistic around the box, tight move. So if you have any questions about any of these pro work or ideas, let us know. Like I said, you know where you can get a hold of us. We really enjoyed the camp. And all we're trying to do is help players get better technically so they can grow here and on the game and then grow off the field and say, hey, look what I do when I put my mind to it, right? That's what we want to do is help them with that growth mindset, because we know sports is a lot more than just being good at a sport. It's like, oh, I got confidence because I'm a good soccer player, or I grew in this, right? So that's what we're trying to hear. That's the mission. It starts with for us, the skills work, the technique, and the confidence they grow through as people and players. So once again, thank you so much for taking the time to watch us. Thank you, FC United, for the opportunity. Thank you, all the players, staff, for doing amazing and making it a really fun week for me. So We really appreciate it. Like I said, we'd love to have you in sometime, see how we're doing things into here in the True Development Center. So take care and have a fantastic summer.